Hey guys, come here. Come here.
Hi everybody. I'm Jason Bear and welcome to another edition of the Conabear Enterprise Weekly Update. I'm in here with SpongeBob and Greta and Gable and the rest of the dogs, and we're running a little bit late on making this movie. One of the things that I've been blogging about, posting about over the last few weeks is the Discipline series of posts. And I wanted to do a video that kind of tied up a couple loose ends and refined my point a little bit. Remember that when it comes to, you can't have a conversation about running sled dogs or training dogs to be gun dogs or hunting sporting dogs without getting into discipline. Because, you know, if you don't instill some discipline, you just have a bunch of, you have an unruly mob of spoiled brats who are, you know, essentially just pets at that point. So there is some level of it, discipline. But what you really need to understand, that when it comes to discipline, especially in a high-end race team like I'm running, it's not the end-all be-all of what you're, you know, what you're trying to accomplish with your dogs. Discipline for me is simply there to establish the parameters of proper behavior, build a relationship with my dogs, and establish myself as the pack leader. But ultimately, when I'm out there on the trail, hi guys, when I'm out there on the trail after a couple days, and mind you, I'm speaking to distance driving. I don't presume to, I'm not really getting into recreational stuff here, and I'm certainly not getting into sprint. But my experience after about a day, any race that takes you over the 24-hour mark, you're starting getting into distance racing. It isn't my discipline, how much I made them be on the right-hand side of the trail, or, you know, how to always look forward, or any one of a number of things you can do to sort of control the way your dogs think. That's not why my dogs go out there and behave heroically and win races for me and still look perfect once we're, you know, blowing Unalaq lead after a week of racing and running straight to Shagtulik after leaving Old Woman, and dogs never looking, even looking at the checkpoint, looking for a place to bed down. It's enough for them that I've asked them to do it, and of course I'm giving it the nod of approval that it can be done. So discipline is very, you got to be really careful with this. I mean, ultimately what you don't want to do is kill this quality through controlling your dogs, this quality of dogs loving you. Ultimately, my belief and our kennel belief is that, and we call our system the relationship training system, is that it's your relationship with your animals that yields such productive results. Discipline, that's just a way for me to establish some parameters. Look at discipline kind of like put yourself in the position of a dog. Some of these really controlling methods, like one that's really popular out in the Midwest, is this very controlling, my dogs have to be on the right-hand side, they always have to be just perfect, and they have to come to me for authorization of anything that they do. How hard they pull, how often they eat, when they eat, how they look when they're eating, all these different things that are basically meant to just control the animal. Put yourself in that position. It'd be like being an office worker and having your boss come out and go, well, old Fred there, his stapler's on the right-hand side of the desk, and I want to instill some discipline on him, so I'm going to make sure that today he knows that I'm going to be really upset with him if he doesn't put his stapler on the left-hand side of the desk. And then, so, you know, he goes over there, and the boss kind of bosses you into moving your stapler for no other reason than just to be controlling. But then when your stapler's on the left-hand side of the desk the next day, he comes back and says, well, you need to move it to the right. You want to be really careful that you don't kill what's beautiful about your dog team through seeking to be too controlling. It's fine to have a little discipline. They need to know your control. They need to know your big tone of voice when something's going wrong. But please, when you're out there and you're running your dogs, remember, it's the love of their master and their pack leader that's really getting you the results. Discipline is just a way to help find your path to getting to being the pack leader. Anyway, you guys have a nice week. Remember, not all good ideas have to be your own. See you next week. Good boys.